Are you surprised to see me? You thought I died in 1955? You are right. Although, according to my theory about special relativity, it would indeed be possible, at least theoretically, that I'm still alive. Let me explain you why. In physics, one tries to understand and to determine laws underlying natural phenomena. To do so, one needs to refer on defined units, such as seconds to measure time, or meters to measure length. In 1905, my reflections led me to a quite revolutionary theory. I proposed to consider time as a relative value and not anymore as an absolute one. In other words, the conception of time is dependent on the speed and point of view of the observer. Ready to go? You have 10 seconds to run the 100 meters.
Oh, easy man.
Excuse me. May I have a couple of seconds more, please?
Sounds incredible to you? However, it's very simple. Look, light has a constant speed in vacuum. Thus, one could define the unit of time being the period that light needs to cover the distance from the ceiling to the ground. Now let's change our point of view and observe what occurs if our newly designed measuring instrument moves. You see, the distance is much longer, but the speed of light is still the same. Apparently, time lasts longer when one moves fast. It's a phenomenon which I call the dilatation of time.
News from today! Professor Tic-Tac will prove experimentally the dilatation of time.
You are wondering why we do not notice this difference in time while traveling? Well, these effects are only perceptible when one moves at speeds close to the light, which is about 300,000 kilometers per second. To give you an idea, in 1 second, light can circle 7 times around the Earth. That's 1,000,000 times quicker than our airplanes. To detect the time dilatation at airplane velocity, we need atomic clocks able to measure extremely small fractions of seconds. Imagine that speed does not only change the time flow, but also dimensions. The faster an object moves, the more its length is contracted in direction of the movement. Of course, you are going to ask,
but finally, on what the hell can we rely if neither time nor space are absolute values? We live in a crazy world!
No, don't worry, everything is fine. My theory of special relativity proposes a completely new concept and suggests that space and time are strongly linked to give a more fundamental and absolute entity called space-time. You just have to consider time as an additional dimension. Sure, our perceptive faculty is not trained to imagine such a fourth dimension. So, I will simplify the model by reducing the three-dimensional space to just one dimension. Let's have a look at this world of dots and lines through a slot. Actually, moving this slot represents the flow of time. Oh, that's funny. One would say a moving bomb. Let's change our point of view by rotating the template. Now the bomb appears to be shorter, and yet it's the same bomb. Apparently, space and time can differ for two observers, although space-time is the same one for both. Effects like dilatation of time and length contraction can be explained by such rotations in space-time, which finally represent nothing else than the velocity of the observers. But there is an unsurmountable speed limit, the speed of light. absolutely nothing can pass over this limit, and this fact guarantees the law of causes and effects, which means that causes always precede the effects. In other words, one can travel in the future, but never return in the past. For you, I will make an exception. Here, this button allows you to see once more my explanation of the theory of special relativity.